Welcome to today's video. Today we're taking a look at the Razer Kairos Pro and seeing why this is probably one of my favorite Razer headsets today. So let's get into it. This is the Razer Kairos Pro, and similar to the Kraken V3 that I reviewed a while ago, it is equipped with Razer's HyperSense feature. It can connect to multiple different platforms like PS5, PS4, PC, mobile, Switch, and even Mac. And with the Kairos Pro, it is easier than ever to switch between these different devices since you have both Bluetooth and a 2.4 GHz connection, which can easily be switched with a push of the button on the headset itself. Now in the box, you do get the headset itself, your wireless dongle, a USB-A to female USB-C cable to connect devices that don't have USB-C ports, like for example, older PCs that may not have USB-C ports or any other device that may only have a USB-A that you can connect it to, a charging cable, and you also have your removable boom mic, your manual, stickers, and thank you letter, which is sort of the standard for Razer products. For me, straight out of the box, I like the Kairos Pro more than the Kraken V3 and the Barracuda X, and number one is simply because of the color scheme. Now, I really do love the black and white aesthetics that they have on this headset, and it really does match the PS5 since this is a headset for PS5 mainly, and the Razer Chroma RGB on the sides looks like it's behind a frosted piece of glass, which up close just makes the headsets look even more premium. Secondly is the adapter, and with the Barracuda X you had a symmetrical USB-C dongle, which meant that the USB port was actually in the middle, and if you use that on a PS5, on the front of the PS5, you actually covered up the USB-A port on the front, which is of course the easiest one to use when charging your controllers, which meant that if you use the Barracuda X's on your PS5, you actually lost your front USB-A port. But now with the Kairos Pros, you do have an offset USB-C dongle, which means that if you use it the correct way around, you'll actually not block the USB-A port on the front. And of course, if you use it the wrong way around, you're just gonna block off more of that port. But just remember when you're plugging it in to make sure that it's actually pointing down instead of up towards the USB-A port. And then lastly was the fact that it can connect to a smartphone via Bluetooth, whereas with the Barracuda X, once again, you had to actually plug in that dongle into your smartphone to use it wirelessly with your smartphone. But with this one, you can easily just connect via Bluetooth to your smartphone, and then when you're done listening to music or having your call on your phone, you can simply switch back to your 2.4 GHz connection, continue on gaming, or if you have a PC or a laptop that has Bluetooth connectivity, it means that you can leave the dongle in your PS5 and just switch between those by actually just double tapping the switch button on the headset itself, which is kind of similar to actually pressing the like and subscribe on this video. It really does help the channel out a lot. And if you enjoy videos like these, then this is the place for you. Now, the battery life of the Kairos Pro is fairly impressive, with 20 hours battery life with RGB and haptics on, and up to 50 hours with those features off, meaning that it should at least last you an entire day, and possibly even two if necessary before you even have to recharge these headsets. And then as far as controls go on the headset itself, on your left side you have your mic mute switch, your volume dial, your on-off switch, your charging point, and your mic input. And then on the right ear cup, you have the switch button that can be used to either switch between the EQ settings with a single press or switch between 2.4 GHz or Bluetooth with a double press. Then you also have your mic monitoring volume dial and the haptics button that can be pressed to change the intensity of the haptics. And each of the intensities does have their own little jingle, so you don't have to actually go into any sort of software to see which stage you are on. You can simply dial through them until you hear it actually turn off, and then you can start from there and just sort of memorize the intensity of the sound to the intensity of the haptics that you have set. Now, the Razer Kairos Pro does not actually make use of the Razer Synapse app on your desktop, but rather, since you can connect it to your smartphone, once you've connected it to your smartphone, you can download the Razer Audio app and control everything from there. Now, from the app itself, you can check your battery levels, your firmware, change EQ, and so much more, meaning that you never have to connect these to your PC. And since they don't actually work with Razer Synapse, you don't really have any benefit from using that. And you can even download Razer Chroma for your smartphone and change the RGB via your smartphone as well, meaning that you can change all of this on the fly, whether you're busy traveling or if you're home, busy between games, you can easily just connect to your smartphone and then just change all of those settings and jump right back into the action. Now, as far as mic quality goes, I can say two things about it. Number one, it is a very directional mic, meaning that you really want to get that mic as close as possible to your face. Otherwise, you're going to actually lose a lot of quality and a lot of audio. But that is, of course, a good thing, especially if you're going to be using this for streaming and content creation, as it will really cut out all of those keyboard and mouse clicks, as well as your environment noise. And of course, that's always a good thing. But then secondly, it is still just a headset mic, and the quality is pretty average, and pretty average for something that you can expect from a headset. Now, here's a little test of the headset mic itself, so you can listen for yourself how the actual mic sounds.
And this is the audio quality of the Razer Kyra Pro, and this is sort of what you can expect from the headset mic itself. For me now in the headset, it sounds very boomy, it sounds very deep-endy, and it doesn't have a lot of clear highs, so it does sound like a headset mic at the end of the day. Now, as you can see, as soon as I start moving, you can actually start hearing less and less. So you do want to make sure that you actually keep the mic as close as possible to your mouth. That also means that this windsock is going to come in handy. And as soon as you start taking it off, you're going to get a lot of that breathing noises on top of it and a lot of those plosives. And since it is really close to your face, you're going to get a lot of those. So for maybe using this, just make sure that you keep this on, get the best audio quality out of this headset as possible.
Now, on the build quality side of the headset feels really sturdy. It doesn't crack or creak when you're actually adjusting it or opening it up. There are markers to show you how far each ear cup is adjusted, and has a nice metal strip on the inside. The headset also feels comfortable to wear, and the haptics for me still is a really cool feature and something that you want to play around definitely for different scenarios to actually get the best intensity that suits you in each and every different scenario that you may actually use this headset in. Now, the haptics for me on the Kyra Pro felt a little better than that of the Kraken V3. Could be because I haven't tested the Kraken V3 in quite some time, but it does feel like the haptics are more haptic-y, and it doesn't interfere with the audio as much as it did with the Kraken V3. And the audio for me was still really good, even on the highest haptic on the Kyra Pro, compared to how it was with the Kraken V3. If I went anything more than medium, the audio actually started getting a little bit more distorted, and it didn't sound as good as it did on lower haptic settings. Now, overall, I was really impressed with the Razer Kyra Pro on all levels. The build quality was good, they sound good, they look good, and the fact that you can connect it to so many different devices and you can connect it via the dongle and Bluetooth really makes it a really good option for anybody looking for a wireless headset, regardless of the connection type that you're actually looking for. And for all the reasons mentioned in this video, I really do believe that the Razer Kyra Pros are worth the money, and if you're looking for a wireless headset, that this is a really solid option for anybody out there. Now, if you want to compare the Razer Kyra Pro to the Barracuda X and the Kraken V3, I've left links to those videos in the cards as well as in the description below. And then if you want to buy the Razer Kyra Pros, I've left links where you can actually purchase these headsets down in the description below as well. And some of those links are affiliate links, so if you make a purchase using that, it really does support the channel, and I really do appreciate it. And then until next time, cheers.